Subscribe to Emmanuel tutorials and press the bell icon for notifications.
Hello everyone, welcome to Emmanuel tutorials. Today we'll be seeing basic operations on signals, but this one is going to be with discrete time signals. We have brought this video because it was asked by many students to be made. So first, we'll see what are the operations which we'll be seeing. Amplitude scaling, addition, subtraction, multiplication, time shifting, time scaling, time reversal. Now if you consider a signal, it's always drawn in between two axes, the horizontal and vertical axis. The horizontal axis is the time axis. Now here, it's a discrete time signal, so it will be n axis, and the amplitude axis, which is this one, which is the vertical one. When you perform the first four operations, it will affect only the amplitude axis, that is this one. And when you perform the last three operations, it will affect the n axis values. So now let's see an example of each so that you'll be able to understand better. First, we'll go with amplitude scaling. In amplitude scaling, this is how the signal gets. So y of n, which is the output signal, will be scaled by a value, suppose a. So a into x of n is y of n. Now suppose we take the input signal x of n as this. And all these values are 1. And if we want to find of y of n, which is equal to 3 times x of n, let's try drawing the resultant signal. So this is the amplitude axis, and this is the time axis, which is n. Now for amplitude scaling, you'll be only considering the amplitude axis. So the values will change only along this direction. So the values of the signal at each n axis values will be multiplied by whatever a is given. So here a is 3. So and the signal is starting from minus 2. So that is not going to change. It is going to remain minus 2 and it will end at plus 2. And at minus 2, the value of our signal is 1. So 1 into 3 is 3. So this will be the resultant at minus 2. Similarly, at minus 1, the value is going to be 1 into 3. Similarly, at 0, the value is going to be 1 into 3. So let's write this value. At 1, again 1 into 3, and at 2, again 1 into 3. So this will be the resultant signal, which is y of n is equal to 3 times x of n. This could be also a fractional value, maybe 1 by 3 x of n. Then you just have to reduce the amplitude. So it will be somewhere here. And here you can write the amplitude as 1 by 3. So all the values will become with amplitude 1 by 3, but nothing will change on the n axis. Now the next one which we'll see is addition. So here we'll have to take two signals. Let's take a rect kind of signal. and a triangular kind of signal to be x2 of n. So this is 0, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, and these all have amplitude 1. This is x1 of n, and x2 of n, this amplitude is 2, this is 1, and this is 0.5. This is the n axis, and minus 1, minus 2, 0, 1. Now, if we have to find out y of n, which is x1 of n plus x2 of n, what we'll have to do is, again, nothing is going to change on the n-axis. So, first, we'll find out the value which is to the extreme left, which will be the starting value of our y of n. So here we can see that both the signals are starting at minus 2, so our extreme end is minus 2. So our resultant signal will start from minus 2, and extreme right we have the value as 2. So it is going to be 2. Suppose we had another value here, 3. So extreme right will be 3, so we'll end our signal at 3. 2, 1. Minus 1 and 0. Now at minus 2, x1 of n's value is 1 and x2 of n's value is 0.5. So the resultant signal will have a value of 1 plus 0.5 because it's going to change along the amplitude axis. So amplitude of x1 of n is 1, amplitude of x2 of n is 0.5. So 1 plus 0.5 is 1.5. At minus 1, amplitude of x1 of n is 1, amplitude of x2 of n is 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. At 0, amplitude of x1 of n is 1, of x2 of n is 2. So 1 plus 2 is 3. Similarly, at 1, x1 of n's value is 1, x2 of n's value is 1. So it's going to be again 2 over here. At 2, the amplitude of x1 of n is 1, amplitude of x2 of n is 0.5. So it's going to be, resultant is 1 plus 0.5, which is 1.5. And similarly at 3, amplitude of x1 of n is 1, amplitude of x2 of n is 0. So 1 plus 0 is 1. So this is the resultant signal. You can also show that this is 0.5 here so that we'll be able to map it. And here it is 1.5 and 2.5 so that we'll be able to map the values of the signals. Now let's do subtraction using the same signal. So we calculate y of n is equal to x1 of n minus x2 of n. Now, we'll follow the same process, but we'll be subtracting the amplitudes of the signals. So, let's draw the axis of y of n. This is the n axis and this is the amplitude axis. And we have the extreme values as minus 2 and 3, 1, 2, 3. Now x1 of n's value is 1 at minus 2, and x2 of n's value is 1 is 0.5 at minus 2. So 1 minus 0.5 will be 0.5. So here at minus 2, our value will be 0.5. And minus 1 x1 of n's value is 1 and x2 of n's value is also 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0. So here there is no signal. At 0, x1 of n's value is 1, x2 of n's value is 2. So 1 minus 2 is minus 1. So this signal will be the negative axis. At 1, x1 of n's value is 1 and x2 of n's value is 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0. At 2, x1 of n's value is 1, x2 of n's value is 0.5. So 1 minus 0.5 is 0.5. And at 3, x1 of n's value is 1 and x2 of n's value is 0. So 1 minus 0, which is 1. So this is 0.5, 1 and minus 1. So this will be the resultant signal if we subtract x1 of n and x2 of n. Next we will see multiplication. We'll use the same signals. X1 of n into x2 of n, which is y of n. Now again, it's not going to affect the time axis, so we will draw the give the extreme points of x1 of n and x2 of n as our y of n's extreme points. So same thing, our signal is going to start from minus 2 and end at plus 3. This is the amplitude axis. We can even extend this below so that we can accommodate the negative values. Now let's start multiplying the amplitudes. X1 of n at minus 2 is 1 and x2 of n is 0.5. So 1 into 0.5 is 0.5. X1 of n at minus 1 amplitude is 1 and for x2 of n the amplitude is 1. So 1 into 1 is 1. At 0, x1 of n's value is 1 and x2 of n's value is 2. So 1 into 2 is 2. At 1, again x1 of n's value is 1 and x2 of n's value is 1. So 1 into 1 is 1. Similarly, these 1 into 0.5 and 1 into 0, because third value is 0 in the x2 signal. So this will be 0. So this is the resultant signal y of n, which is the multiplication of x1 of n into x2 of n. Now we'll start the time operations. So time shifting, time scaling and time reversal. So first one is time shifting. Time shifting can be of two types, delay and advance. Delay always shifts the signal to the right hand side and advance shifts the signal to the left hand side. So it can be x of n minus n naught, which is delay, and x of n plus n naught is advance. Now let's see an example for delay. Suppose we take this signal. This is x of n. These values are 3, 2, 1. And the signal is present at minus 1, 0, 1. And this is the n-axis. Now we want to shift this x of n by 3. So first we will do the delay operation. Delay operation, as I said, it shifts the signal to the right by whatever amount we give here. That is n naught here. So it is 3. We'll shift the signal to the right by 3. So let's draw the axis again. Now, the value at minus 1 will go to minus 1 plus whatever n naught value. So, minus 1 plus 3 will be 2. So, this signal will appear, this part of the signal will appear at 2 in y of n. So, at 2, our value is going to be plus 1. Similarly, 0th value will appear at 0 plus 3, which is 3. So, that will be 2 here. Similarly, the value at 1 will appear at 1 plus 3, which is 4. So, these are the values 1, 2 and 3. So, you can see here that the values have changed in the time axis and not in the amplitude axis when you do time shifting. Now we'll see advanced time shifting. We'll use the same signal. So now we are going to perform x of n plus 3. So as I said, advancing means shifting the signal to the left. So let's draw the axis. This is the n-axis. This is y of n. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. 1, 2, 3. Now, we have the first point of the signal at minus 1. So, the first part of the signal, that is this part, will appear at minus 1 minus the shift. So, here we have the shift as 3. So it is going to be at minus 1 minus 3, which is at minus 4. So the first part of the signal will appear at minus 4 with value 1 or amplitude 1. Similarly, the next part of the signal is at 0, which will appear at 0 minus 3, that is the shift, which is equal to minus 3 with value 2. Similarly, at 1 we have a signal which has amplitude of 3, which will appear at 1 minus 3, which is minus 2. This is the resultant signal. So this is performing of advancing, which is n naught over here. Next we'll perform time scaling. Now, time scaling can be quite confusing when it comes to discrete signals because we don't have intermediate points between the integers. So, in the time axis for a discrete time signal, you can only have whole numbers. You cannot have decimal numbers. So, at that time when you perform time scaling, it becomes difficult. Now, similar to time shifting, time scaling also has two types. You can have compression or contraction of a signal, or you can have expansion of a signal. So when you divide x of n's value by some value, this is expansion, and when you multiply it by a value, this is compression. So this is an example of compression. This is an example of expansion. Now we will see x of a n, that is compression example. So let's take x of 2n, and we'll consider the same signal. Now for finding out x of 2n, you'll have to divide the values of n at each point by whatever a you're multiplying it with. So here we have 2, so you'll divide the time axis values by 2. So now we'll draw the resultant signal. So we have the values at minus 1, 0 and 1. So first we'll divide minus 1 by 2. Dividing minus 1 by 2, we have the value as minus 0.5. And minus 0.5 doesn't exist in a discrete time signal. So what happens is, this signal will not appear, this part of the signal will not appear in the resultant signal. So we eliminate this. Now the next part of the signal appears at 0. 0 divided by 2 is 0. So this part of the signal will appear at 0th point in the resultant signal. So with amplitude 2. Now similarly, next the signal appears at 1, and 1 divided by 2 is 0.5. Again, 0.5 doesn't exist in a discrete time signal. So this part of the signal is also eliminated from the resultant signal. So x of 2n is equal to this. This is the resultant y of n. Now you can see that the signal is compressed, part of the signal is missing, or the values have on the time axis have become smaller. Now next we will see expansion. Suppose we perform x of 1 by 2n. Now what you'll have to do is, this is as good as x of n by 2. So we are going to multiply the values. Now in the previous example we had divided the value of a, here we are going to multiply the value of a. So the first part of the signal appears at minus 1, so in the resultant signal it will appear at minus 1 into 2, which is minus 2. Let's draw the signal. So at minus 2, we'll have the first part of the signal with value as 1. Now next part of the signal appears at 0 with value 2. So 0 into 2 is 0. So in the resultant signal, you'll have the value at 0 with amplitude 2. Similarly, next part of the signal appears at 1. So 1 into 2 is 2. So it'll appear at 2 in the resultant signal with amplitude 3. So this is the resultant signal when you perform expansion of the signal. So you can see that the extreme values have increased compared to the original signal x of n. Now we'll perform the last operation, which is time reversal. Now we'll use the same original signal which we used, which is x of n as this, 1, 2 and 3, and we'll perform the time reversal. Time reversal, as the name suggests, it just mirrors or reverses the values of the signals on the time axis. So the operation is x of minus n. Now if you have to perform time reversal, you just shift or just place the values at the left hand side of the amplitude axis on the right hand side, and the right hand side's values on the left hand side, and keep the zero value as it is. So at zero you have the value as 2, This will remain as it is in y of n. At 1, you have the value as 3. So this will appear at minus 1 with value as 3. And at minus 1, you have the value as 1. So it will appear on the right hand side of the amplitude axis with value 1. So you just have to interchange the values multiplying them by minus 1. So here we have seen all the basic operations that can be performed. In the next video, we will see solved examples using these basic operations or the combination of different basic operations, which will help you find it easier to solve discrete time signal problems. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any doubts or concepts on which you would like videos to be made, please mention them in the comments. Please like, share and subscribe to our channel for more. Thank you.
Subscribe to Emmanuel Tutorials and press the bell icon for notifications.